Today's collectible spot, we are having a look at the Friday 13th Part 6 Jason Lives Replica Mask. Spot picked this up as well as a couple of other masks from the folks over at Fiberglass Masks, which I've picked up a series of masks from before and likely will continue to pick up masks from because they are truly authentic reproductions of how the masks appear in the various Jason Voorhees movies. Now, this particular movie, Jason Voorhees was wearing this mask and was worn by C.J. Graham, an actor and stuntman, one of the many different stuntmen that donned the hockey masks. This particular mask is notable for the fact that it's a very large mask. It's about the same size as the Part 8 mask. It is certainly a lot wider, which is one of the things that stands out about this particular mask over some of the other Jason masks. In fact, even when you see him wearing it, C.J. Graham, like, the mask encompasses most of Jason's front face, so that when you look at him from head on, you really don't see any of the rest of Jason's head, except for really the mask itself. And that's one thing that stands out about the Jason 6 mask, is that Friday 13th Part 6's mask was very, very large. Just by a sheer comparison, I'll reach off camera here, and we're going to grab another mask that we've just recently had a look at, and that is the Part 4 mask, the final chapter. Now, one thing to note, though, about the Part 3 and Part 4 masks is that they're not as wide, but they are a lot longer. That's one of the notable things. They are a lot longer. So if you stack it against next to, well, Part 6 mask, it's a lot longer, but Part 6 is a much wider looking mask. And that's something that carries over to the later Jason movies, is that he does have the wider mask. Part 7, you could debate, yeah, it's not quite a wide mask because the majority of the mask is quite chewed up over the course. Well, even really at the beginning of the movie, it's considerably chewed up because Jason is found at the bottom of the lake. But prior to that, you have a mask that looks like this, something that Tommy Jarvis, for some reason, wants to bring with him when he digs up, which in itself is a weak sort of plot, but Tommy Jarvis wants to go back and dig up Jason just to make sure he's dead. And along the way, he brings the mask. Well, we know how well that worked out. Jason is resurrected through lightning bolt, flash, and of course he's brought back more as a zombie Jason rather than the stalking menace that he is in the first, well, the first four movies, not technically counting five. As for the mask itself, it's a faithful reproduction of the Jason Voorhees mask. And also, too, the level of detail that fiberglass masks put into their pieces. If you do like a Google search of Friday 13th Part 6 Jason Lives, if you look at some of the images, you'll even see that the chevron decal or design on the front here has the exact same indentations or wear away areas that the mask here is present as well, or featuring here as well. The mask is almost more of a, initially in watching the movie, I thought the mask was more white, but the mask is almost more this kind of yellowy kind of brown, almost borderline like a brownish beige. Also for the strapping, it's now swapped out for more of a leather strapping, which has been strapped and fastened on the back there. You'll also know too, it's an official fiberglass masks, as they indicated on the inside there, fiberglassmasks.com. I would say it's not necessarily one of my favorite Jason masks, and I guess I just translate that to, it's not my favorite Jason design. I don't like the utility belt, the little belt of tools that he carries around with him. I don't like the gloves, and I don't like the head. The head of that kind of greenish color. I get that he's a zombie, but it's not been one of my favorite. It's not one of my favorite Jason designs. I like the mask, but I guess because like the total package, the total design of him, it's not one of my personal favorite Jason designs. I do like the mask though, and I like how it's wide, so that it's the one movie that you can think of for Friday 13th where, looking at Jason, all you see is his mask. You don't see really his ears that much until he kind of turns sideways. What you predominantly see is his mask, and that's because the mask is so much wider. A beautiful piece, though. And the thing about fiberglass masks, though, is when you go to their website, you can get, for example, the Part 6 mask, but then you can get varying degrees of how the mask appears throughout the movie. As the movie progresses, the masks get a little bit more worn. You might have more wear marks on the bridge or nose area of the mask. You might get more wear marks. You might get more blood marks. So they really cover the movie masks right through the entire movie. So like part 8, for example, he has masks that have more of the slime from the toxic waste near the end of the movie. He has a more cleaner mask from the beginning of the movie. And he has masks throughout the whole course of the movie as well. I kind of went for just a more pristine looking design of the part 6 mask, but he has other ones to choose from as well. I'll put the link down below if you guys are interested in heading over. Prices are pretty reasonable as well. Like if you want a high-end replica mask, it doesn't get any more authentic than this, other than lifting the mask from the actual set of the movie, and I'm pretty sure they would not like that. But it's as authentic as you can get for a replica mask. Today we were having a look though at the Jason Voorhees mask, replica mask from Friday the 13th Part 6, Jason Lives. Certainly thanks for watching as you always do, guys, and stay tuned. Spot's going to have more collectible spots heading your way. Thanks for watching. See you next time.